Nancy Pelosi sends a letter to colleagues telling them how committees are now building out the next stimulus package, while many people in Congress push for a reconciliation vote to bypass Republicans for the next stimulus check package. Hello and welcome to today's January 28th, third stimulus check update and trending news. Now, if you're a subscribed member of my community, then welcome back. And if you're not, consider subscribing right now. All right, now make sure to sign up for the cash contest giveaway that ends on February 1st. So just in a couple of days, my family and I are helping five families with $400. So make sure to check out the link below. I'm going to try to put together something in February, but it's been a little bit slow with getting new video sponsors, but I'm going to keep fighting to help my community as much as I can. Now, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi released a letter to her Democrat colleagues last night, letting them know which committees were starting to work on drafting the language for the next stimulus check package. She also alluded to the fact that if they can't get Republicans on board, they will push the bill through. She then thanked members of Congress for their flexibility with their schedules, hinting at the fact that they may be called back at any time to come and vote on the language of the new stimulus check package. People are still receiving checks and still receiving prepaid debit cards. So if you have not received your $600 second stimulus check, check in the mail, it could still be coming. Each day I see people say, yay, it finally came. Hey, let the community know. So don't give up yet, but just know that you may need to file a tax return if you don't get that. But people are still getting them in the mail. While the Senate is unlikely to get the votes needed to impeach President Trump in February, there will most likely still be a trial to weigh the evidence and shout opinions. But at the end of the day, it does look like he will not be impeached, just like as happened during the first impeachment trial. Congress has selected 100 jurors from congressional leaders to hear the evidence. But ultimately, the impeachment will come down to the 100 state senators. And right now, it does not look like they have the votes to convict President Trump. However, this means that Congress and the Biden administration can get back to focusing on the American people by getting a stimulus check and a stimulus package out to the economy. More and more, it looks like Democrats will be using one of their 9 reconciliation votes to push through either the $1.9 trillion Biden proposal or something similar to it. As of right now, stimulus checks and unemployment money are still on the table. Yesterday, Representative Steny Hoyer, who ranks just under Nancy Pelosi in the House of Representatives, called for a reconciliation vote early next week, pushing his colleagues to make this happen fast for the American people. My best guess is that we will see Democrats use one of their 9 reconciliation votes and get the stimulus out faster than trying to go back and forth and have this thing take another 9 months to get people help. Now, the Federal Reserve announced last night that they will not be raising interest rates. In fact, Jerome Powell of the Federal Reserve said they will keep interest rates near zero for the foreseeable future to help the country recover and to help aid with the cost of the next stimulus package, as they will have to borrow that money in order to help American families. So the Fed is going to keep interest rates near zero so that borrowing $1.9 trillion is not as harmful to the economy as it could be. When asked if all this money printing will lead to inflation or hyperinflation, Jerome Powell said he wasn't worried about inflation and that the Federal Reserve knows how to handle hyperinflation. He said the path of the economy will depend on the course of the virus. Powell also told Congress not to be afraid to do more stimulus because to do too little could be worse than doing too much. Jerome Powell also said he's not worried about the stock market. However, less than 24 hours after saying this, the stock market had its biggest drop in several months, and nearly every stock I own went red. So he was off on that one. Also, I would just urge caution right now. There is a lot of stock market manipulation going on with companies such as Nokia, GameStop, and AMC Movie Theaters, just to name a few. Their stocks rose like it was jumping over the Empire State Building, only to have major drops all within one day. I'm hoping to come on tonight live and talk about this because this is really damaging, especially to the middle class and the average investor. What is coming out of Wall Street and big money is that they have figured out how to make lots of money while leaving the American average American investor holding the losses. So again, this could be breaking news. I'm researching and we'll be going live to share this information. Now, Representative Ro Khanna of California suggested to President Biden that lowering the income caps and giving less stimulus to less people would be a very bad move and would show that he does not care about the middle class. At this point, we don't know if President Biden means smaller checks or checks to a smaller group, or if he means both. There's still nothing in writing from this huge Biden proposal, but I'm trying to read between the lines for my community. And what I think they mean is that they would lower the income cap, which would mean less total money going towards stimulus checks, but that it would still be a $1,400 stimulus check. Anyway, more information needs to come out about this, but basically Ro Khanna is saying, don't change your story, don't break your promise. You told all these people you would do a $1,400 check, and many of them are now counting on that money. Now, in trending news, according to a new study, between natural immunity and vaccines, the United States already has around 12% protection against COVID, which means that things are trending in a positive direction. A new study also showed that taking naps, especially for people 60 and older, leaves you with a sharper mind and more agility. So if you needed permission to take a nap, now you have it. It's for your health. President Biden signed an executive order to reopen enrollment for the Affordable Care Act, or it's popularly named Obamacare. So that is reopening for people to get in on health care. 847,000 Americans filed for first-time unemployment this week, which is too many, but it is lower than the 914,000 that filed last week. Lastly, a new bill seeks to tax Americans based on the number of miles they drive in a year, as if we didn't need to be taxed to death any further. So, yay for more taxes. All right, now this is my update for today. As I know more, I will definitely share more. It does look like between what's going on in Nancy Pelosi's office and these committees that things are moving towards getting the stimulus package done with the stimulus checks. It also does look like the Democrats are ramping up to use one of their 9 reconciliation votes to push this through. Now, before you go, make sure to check out the link for the giveaway. We're going to help 5 families with $400. Also, check out my video from earlier today about the benefits of investing in silver. And also, I'll put up the most recent video on my wife's channel where she talks to women about not being so hard on yourself. Anyway, I want to remind you that you are amazing. I appreciate you being in my community, and I'll see you on the next video.